Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited because I am going to be talking about embracing your singleness. And I actually initially wasn't thinking about doing a video like this, but one second. One of my most favorite things about starting this channel is that I get to read your stories. You guys are leaving comments and what you've been through and what you're struggling with. It's so cool because what I'm putting out there is actually encouraging you guys, and that's exactly why I started this channel. It's just really fun to hear your stories. So yes, thank you guys so much. It makes my heart so happy. So today, you guys asked for it. I'm sharing it, embracing your singleness. And you know what? Singleness was not that long ago for me. I've only been married for, at the end of this month, it's gonna be a year since Will proposed to me, but 6 months since we've been married. Time goes by so fast, doesn't it? I think it was a really good time to kind of just talk about it because it is fresh in my mind. And what I say today, I'm not like any kind of like psychologist or anything like that. Like, it's just kind of the things that helped me embrace my singleness. And I really hope that it helps you, because guys, no lie, I was definitely that girl that was like, I feel like everywhere I walked, I would see couples, or I would see someone that just got pregnant, people that are getting married, and I was just like, why is everyone married and together, and except for me, I'm like the only single person in the whole world, and I'm all by myself, and no one likes me, I'm not pretty enough, something is wrong with me, am I not supposed to get married? Like, I was just like moping around life, not happy single, and like up until a year before I met my husband is when I really like shifted. I have walked away at, now I'm 31, I just turned 31 January 11th. I feel like I walked away with zero regrets. Singleness is so special, and I really want you guys to grasp it and just how to enjoy it. So I have three tips, kind of just gonna be chatting with you guys about it, but three tips that really helped me embrace my singleness. And we're gonna start with number one. The first thing, and I feel like this is probably the most important thing about, or how to embrace your singleness, and this is probably one of the key things that has really, really helped me enjoy my singleness, and it is perspective. Perspective is everything. If you are constantly thinking about what you don't have, what you wish you had, scrolling on Instagram of all the families that you wish you had, you're gonna feel awful. I'm actually using the book that I really wanted to show you guys as like a stand thing for my tripod because it's too small, but I'll link it down below. It's called Switch On Your Brain by Dr. Caroline Leaf, and I barely picked it up like a couple weeks ago, but it just talks about like the power of the mind, and what you think of, your thoughts, your thought life is how you're gonna feel. And it's just like, we are in charge of our emotions, we're in charge of how we react to our circumstances. That right there is huge, because if you are not controlling your thoughts, you are not gonna be happy. If you are just thinking negatively all the time, like, it's not just like a scripture in the Bible that talks about like, what a man thinks, so is he. It's actually science, and that's what this book does. What you think is how you're gonna feel. So I just really encourage you guys, for perspective, to really take care of your thought life, thinking about the positive things that singleness brings. You're not in a place where you're emotionally and mentally and physically happy and content with where you're at, where you can just take care of yourself and you're a happy person as an individual, you are not going to be happy in a relationship, because you're essentially looking for a relationship, looking for someone else to validate you and to make you feel better about yourself. And that's not healthy. And I was there for a long time, guys, a long time. So I know exactly how you feel. So I'm telling you right now that I just like switched my mind, and I was like, okay, actually I have to come to a place in my life where I'm mentally, emotionally, physically happy by myself, genuinely happy. Because I was talking to my husband about this, and you can't fake it. You can't fake it that you're happy single, because it's like, you can genuinely tell when someone is happy when they're single. And my husband was like, that was one of the things that was the most attractive to me about you. Oh, there's a plane going by. Sorry if you can hear that. He was like, you just seemed like you were just like on, like you were on your own path. You had goals. You were just doing your own thing. You were happy. So he just saw me and he was like, whoa, this girl like has it together. How can I add to that instead of being like, how can I how can I complete her? Because that's not what a relationship is. He doesn't complete me. God completes me. And we are capable to be on our own and be happy in the midst of community and family and friends, but you don't need a intimate romantic relationship to complete you. Yeah, that's honestly one of the things that he told me. He's like, you just seemed like how can I get this girl? Because she seems so good on her own. And guys, I still had lonely days, but I didn't stay there. You know, like I'm gonna trust God. I'm good where I'm at. Like, I'm happy, I'm working on myself, I'm working on my growth as a person. So I just feel like perspective is everything. Think good thoughts, think of what you have right now because the grass is always greener on the other side. So that's the first thing. Sorry, I was kind of long, but I feel like that one is like super important. Okay, number two, working on yourself, bettering yourself, committing to loving yourself. And with that, I mean, you need to work on yourself for yourself. Not to get someone, not for anyone else. There's only two. For yourself. Working on yourself, loving yourself for yourself. You need to learn to do things that feed your soul, that grow you as a person for you, because you're only with you for the rest of your life. People come and go, but you have you for the rest of your life. You see yourself every day. You wake up to yourself every day. You're in your thoughts every day. It's so important to nourish this temple that God has given you, this life that God has given you, and you need to do it for yourself. Working on yourself is getting to know yourself. If you're unaware of where you're at, you're not gonna grow. Like, one of the biggest things is acknowledging where you're at in your life and coming to terms with, ooh, I need to work on that. Like, that's not gonna be good in a relationship. That's not gonna be healthy in a relationship. Like, let's work on that now. Like, let's start making those steps now, like right now. Like when you're done watching this video. Go get this book, Switch On Your Brain. Honestly guys, for me, one of my biggest things that I really struggled with in my singleness when I was working on this journey of embracing it was that I was so unkind to myself. I was so hard on myself. Like every time I would like fail or I was like, oh, like moped even a little bit, I was like, you suck. I was like, you are never gonna get it right. And I was like, oh my gosh, why am I talking to myself like that? Like, you need to learn to be kind to yourself and to give yourself grace and to have patience for your growth and loving on yourself, speaking to yourself. Honestly, the most therapeutic things for me is journaling. I feel like if I don't journal every day, I'm grumpy because I need to put my thoughts somewhere and I need to either say them out loud, which I won't because my husband's usually next to me in the mornings and that's kind of weird for him to just hear all of my thoughts. And then I feel like when you are loving on yourself and you are feeling good about yourself and where you're at and you're growing and all that stuff, you're not gonna be like looking around for all these men or these women to just pay you attention. You're gonna be like, well, I deserve a good person because you are worth it. And honestly, like looking back, when I met my husband, I was like, I deserve this because you do deserve it. And you need to be in that place where you feel like you deserve the best and you don't settle for anybody that gives you attention. You need to know your worth and you need to know that whoever comes into your life is gonna be an addition that's gonna level you up, that's gonna support you and be your biggest cheerleader. It's not gonna be someone that completes you. You need to get out of that mindset because if you step into a marriage like that, it's not gonna be good for your husband and it's not gonna be good for you because every time he messes up, it's gonna bring you to a very low, and it's just gonna become a very unhealthy relationship. So that's number two. Number three, building good quality relationships, friendships around you. With number one about perspective and number two about loving yourself, like you can't do this on your own. Building good quality relationships, it takes a lot of work and it takes being uncomfortable, but getting out there and asking a girl out for a coffee or a girlfriend and a guy friend out for a coffee and putting yourself out there and having those people around you that are gonna tell you things you don't wanna hear and are gonna love on you and be there for you and, you know, gonna be really good company. Like, building a good community is gonna make your singleness so much better because life isn't meant to do, it's not meant to be alone. We're not meant to be isolated human beings. Like, we need community and we need people around us because I really do believe that God works through people to show how much he loves us. And I think that You know, just that friend that you have over for a girl's night or going out to play basketball with the guys. Like, it feeds your soul. Like, you need that. I really do believe that the more you love on yourself and all that, you're gonna attract good quality people in your life. I really do believe that it'll pay off and it'll be so rewarding. So that's really the three main things that I feel like will really help you embrace your singleness. But I can't emphasize more how important number one is: perspective, mindfulness, and really pushing past those thoughts of being like, oh, I don't have anyone and it's Valentine's Day or it's New Year's Eve and I don't have a New Year's Eve kiss. Like, you have to push past those thoughts and you have to like realize that once you see that you're retreating back into a position of lack, then you need to realize, oh no, I'm gonna push past those feelings and those thoughts, because me having someone in my life or having someone on New Year's Eve doesn't define who I am and doesn't give me my happiness. I'm just telling you that number one is so important, and I'm with you guys. I was there for a really long time. It was really hard for me to embrace my singleness, but I came to a place where I really did enjoy my singleness, to a point where when Will asked me out for a date, I was just like, do I even want to go on this date? Like, I'm kind of doing my own thing. And he just came out of nowhere and asked me out for a coffee. And I was like, sure, like, why not? Like, and there was absolutely no pressure on me going out with him, because I wasn't like, is he the one I'm gonna marry? Is he gonna be the one? If he's not, what am I gonna do with my life? Like, there was just no pressure. And I think that is the best way to go into dating, when you are just so confident and happy by yourself. And if I can do it, you guys can do it, because I'm telling you right now, my whole family will tell you that ever since I was a little girl, I always wanted to get married. I just hope that this encourages you guys, because honestly, 100%, it is possible to enjoy your singleness and to embrace it. Whoever you're gonna meet, your future husband or wife is not the person that's gonna complete you. God completes you, and that's just gonna be an addition. So that is my encouragement to you guys of embracing your singleness. Don't waste this season wishing for the next one, because once you get into that season of marriage or dating that someone you really like, you're gonna be wishing for the next one of engagement, and then you're gonna be wishing for the next one of marriage, you're gonna be wishing for the next one of having a family, you're gonna be wishing for the next one of not having a family in the house. Like, God is so good, and he's preparing you in this season. You're in this season for a reason, and God is so intentional, you guys, like, so intentional. He always has something to teach you in every single season, and every single day you're growing, you're learning, and whatever you're gonna learn in this season of singleness, you're gonna take into your marriage. You're gonna take into the next season of life, and it's going to prepare you for what's next to come. So don't waste it. Go full force into everything that you want to learn. So yeah, you guys are the best. You guys have been so supportive, and thank you for watching this video. I really hope that it encouraged you. You're not alone in this journey. There's so many people going through the same thing that you're going through, and I was one of them, and I learned to embrace my singleness. So I love you guys so much. I will see you guys very soon. In the next 2 weeks, I'll be posting, but don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Follow me on Instagram or Facebook. My accounts are down there to keep up with my more day-to-day life. I'll see you soon. Bye.